Today I wanted to talk to you about the differences between wax-based and glycerin-based face paints. There are some differences between these two. They both have their own pros and cons, and I wanted to share them today in this video. So if you are looking for some information on water-based face paint, please keep watching because I will explain a lot of it in the coming video. Let's start with the glycerin-based face paints. These are very soft and very creamy. They are very blendable and are amazing to make a base of your face paint with, as they can absorb more water than wax-based face paints. You are best to use these if you are having someone in your chair that is sweating, because with the glycerin based face paints it wouldn't run down the face as fast as it would with wax based face paints. Well, as you need to add a lot of water to these before they are properly activated, they tend to look a little bit less vibrant than the wax based face paints, and because of their creaminess they tend to be a little bit less suitable to do details and line work with than the wax-based face paints. On to the wax-based face paints like Chameleon and Diamond FX. Well, these just need a little bit of water to activate them, and what you will see when you do that is that you won't get a very creamy substance, but you will get more of an inky substance like when you are watercoloring, and that means that these are amazing to create details and line work in your face paints with. Well, these are highly pigmented. A pro of this is that they look very vibrant on the skin. A con of this is that colors are more difficult to remove from the skin than the glycerin based face paints. And as they are wax based, it's more difficult to work with them in warm weather than the glycerin based face paints are, because the wax, of course, melts in the hot sun. Now we covered all the basics on glycerin based and wax based face paints. I thought it would be fun to share some of my lifesavers with you. So there are just those days when it is extremely warm outside and you still have to face paint, or there are those gigs where you know you are going to meet that extremely sweaty client that does want to be painted but you hate it because after 30 minutes the paint is running down the person's face and you wish you could do something to change that. Well, then you have a product like Skin Prep Pro by Merom, and this is a base for your face paint. So you will get a bit of cotton wool and just dab a very thin layer of this on the skin and let it dry for a few minutes. And what this does is kind of the same as you have with a deodorant. It stops the sweating, or at least it makes the sweating less, and that makes the probability of your face paint being on the skin longer and more beautiful a lot bigger. So this one has helped me out in numerous occasions and I always take it with me. Skin Prep by Merom. This is Barrier Spray by Merom, and this is Prolong by ProAir. They are different products but they have the same use. They will seal your makeup. So you just put on the face paint and give a light mist of one of them, the one you like the most, and that will seal the makeup and they will make it even longer lasting than with a skin prep alone. These work very good on belly pains as well, when a pregnant woman wants to get her clothes back on after having her belly painted. This will protect the belly paint so that once she gets home she can show everybody the beautiful belly paint you did. And my last resource when it comes to protecting my face paint is Mixing Liquid by Merom. This product is meant to mix with stuff like the metallic powder or the precious gem powder, but when you mix it with the water activated makeup instead of mixing it with water, so you don't put any water with your water activated makeup, but you use Mixing Liquid as the medium to activate it with, you will see that it makes a world of difference in how long the paint stays on the skin. So in the most extreme case, you would clean the skin with the Skin Prep, work with the mixing liquid and the water-based face paints without any water, so just this as a medium. And when you are done, you will put some barrier spray over it, and that is the most you can protect your water-based face paint with. So you can use all of them or you can just pick your favorite, but the barrier spray, the skin prep and the mixing liquid can definitely help you when it's warm or when you have a sweaty person to paint. Finally, I think we should talk about removing face paints from the skin, and then I think we have all the basics. Well, what you see when you remove glycerin-based face paint from the skin is that that goes very easily with just a little bit of water and soap and it's gone completely. That is a different story with wax-based face paints, as they are that highly pigmented, they tend to leave stains on the skin. For me personally, it is with reds, with blues and with greens, but that is my skin type. It could be completely different with you. Maybe they don't stain with your skin at all, but I have it with red, blue and green. So what I do when I get home and I had wax-based face paints on my skin is get a special soap. This one is by Chameleon, but there's also one by Diamond Effects, and I know there is one by Superstar, and make a nice foam with it and massage it onto the skin until all the colors leave my skin. They are very nice and easy to work with and work extremely well. Another product that works extremely well, and I didn't really believe this at the beginning, but they do really work, and that is why I'm showing them to you now, are the Wonder Towels makeup removers. So it says soft touch, and that is true. They are very soft and remove any face paint amazingly. So what you do is you just wetten these with water and clean your skin with it like you would with a normal washing cloth, I think, and that leaves no stain. You don't have to add anything to this, no soap or anything to clean your skin. They just work. But well, I understand that you can't give every parent to a child you face painted one of these amazing little towels or a soap like this one. So if you want to help the parents to remove the face paint from their kids at the end of the day again, I would do a business card, my business card, with a little removal instruction on there. And that could either be a baby shampoo or a mini of a soap like this one. I know all the brands have very little soaps for one or two uses in removing face paint, and that would definitely make parents very happy, because on one side they have your business card and they can call you for their next party, and on the other side you solved their problem in cleaning their kid's face at the end of the day. And that kind of covers everything on the differences between glycerin-based and wax-based face paints, what you can do to keep a face paint on your skin longer than it would maybe naturally, and what you can do to easily remove the face paint from the skin again. Well, I definitely hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, don't forget to give it a thumbs up and subscribe to our YouTube channel in the link below to tune on all the videos we upload to this channel. Well, for now, I wish you a wonderful day and I hope to see you next time. Bye!